Big Wireless, any two people can be family and still get the $15 a month rate.
Why don't you just air quote family? I mean, are we not family?
No, 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 we are. I was making a point for them. It's, are you being texting Blake right now?
No. You're aging great, by the way.
You did that at airports, too.
Just saw my car with Carter's.
Yeah, you did.
And you instantly got the best, most competitive offer from our network of thousands of dealers.
So you're selling the car, but $250. You're selling the
car. Car Gurus. Get the best offer for your car.
Isn't cheesy offer so cheesy, airy, and puffy? How'd you do it?
After I did 5,000, you said anything to me, quickly.
What keeps me vital? Time to reflect is vital. Breath is vital. Beyond that, it's vital proteins. Every moment is vital because you are vital.
Days to maintain a U.S. presence near Taiwan.
And we now have the first substantive statement from the Pentagon just a few moments ago from Todd Brazil, the acting DOD press secretary, and he says, and I quote, the PRC has chosen to overreact and use the speaker's visit as a pretext to increase provocative military activity in and around the Taiwan Strait. Part of this overreaction has been strictly limiting its defense engagements when any responsible state would recognize that we need them now the most. Although the PRC has unilaterally turned off a number of defense engagements, we remain open to communication and committing to build crisis communications and risk reduction mechanisms. The Pentagon tonight always worried about just how far this could ratchet up.
Emily on Rambler, Barmstar, thank you so much. And turning to Russia now, and the renewed U.S. efforts to negotiate for the release of both Brittney Griner and Paul Mueller. Griner's lawyers told CNN's Mark Blanken today their court fight isn't over yet, as Russia says it's ready to talk about his fall.
After the harsh verdict against Brittney Griner for drug charges, the WNBA star's lawyer, right after visiting Griner, tells me she's still in shock, but in the fighting spirit.
She's doing better than yesterday. She's still processing what has happened. But we tried to check her up. We told you about this huge support she's getting, in fact, and in Russia now as well, because everybody here is very much surprised with this very harsh sentence.
The court sentenced the two-time U.S. Olympic gold medalist to 9 years in a Russian penal colony. And while her legal team says they will immediately appeal the verdict, which they say was deeply unfair, they welcome a prisoner swap to get Griner back to the U.S.
It's just the perfect thing to get her home, of course, before that she won't get home soon.
Now that the sentence has been handed down, Russia, for the first time, is saying it's willing to engage with the U.S. on a possible exchange. That a mechanism for such swaps was put in place after President Biden's summit with Russian leader Vladimir Putin in Switzerland last year.
As for specifically on the issue of persons convicted in Russia and in the U.S., I've already said that there is the special channel that was agreed to by the presidents. Whatever might be said publicly, this channel is still relevant.
The U.S. has said it's put an offer on the table to get both Brittany Griner and former Marine Paul Whelan, who's currently serving a 16-year sentence in Russia for espionage, which he denies, released. CNN learning that the Biden administration is offering convicted Russian arms dealer Viktor Boot in return. Secretary of State Blinken says Washington will take up Moscow's offer to negotiate.
Week before, as you know, a substantial proposal that Russia has engaged us on. And what Foreign Minister Lavrov said this morning, and said publicly, is that they are prepared to engage through channels being established to do just that, and will be pursuing.
The Kremlin was extremely irritated when the U.S. made its offer public last week. Vladimir Putin's spokesman saying any future talks need to be held in secret or they'll fail.
If we discuss even a few details of prisoner exchanges via the press, then those exchanges will never take place. The Americans have already made that mistake, suddenly deciding to use megaphone diplomacy to resolve these issues. This is not how they are resolved, so we will not give any comments.
And Pamela Bernie Browder is not yet in that very tough deal column. She hasn't been moved there yet. She's still the potential display that she's been in the whole time. That is because all of that is still pending, the appeal that her lawyers say they are going to file. Now, we have one from the lawyers today. Those appeals are usually dealt with very quickly here in Russia. It can take only one trial session to get that over with. And the success rate here in Russia, not very high for appeal.
Republican in Moscow, thank you so much for joining us now to live to discuss all this. Democratic Senator Jill Shaheen of New Hampshire. She serves on the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. Hi, Senator. So the Russian Foreign Minister is talking about negotiating through a quote specified channel between President Putin and President Biden. What does Senator say what that means?
Competition between just a set of policy prescriptions for the nation. It's a competition between people that include Liz Cheney, both the Democratic Party, who believe that we should resolve our differences within the democratic context, within the system of laws and rules, at the foundation of which is if you get the most votes in election, you win.